Guys, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video we're gonna learn another topic, that is negligence. So what is negligence? We will discuss in this video. So please watch this video till the end, because this video is really important for you and there are many questions in the exams comes from this topic, negligence, and this is one of the more important topic of the law of tort. So do watch this video till the end. But before I begin, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't subscribed yet, and if you find this helpful video helpful, then please do hit the like button. Okay, so let's start today's topic. So what is negligence? Negligence, if you see the general meaning of the word negligence, that will be what? Careless. Okay, careless, being careless. Okay, if we say in Hindi, then that will be what? सो अगर हिंदी में बोलें से इट विल बी वॉट गैर जिम्मेदाराना. ओके, गैर जिम्मेदार. ओके, सो केयरलेस, दैट इज नेग्लिजेंस. ओके, सो वेन लाइक वेन यू वेन डू यू कॉल अ पर्सन इज नेग्लिजेंट. ओके, सो दैट वी विल डिस्कस हियर. सो सपोज आई एम अ राइडर. ओके, दिस इज अ वे, दिस इज अ पब्लिक वे, एंड आई एम राइडिंग अ वे, आई एम राइडिंग अ बाइक हियर. ओके, I'm riding a bike here. So I owe a duty. So I have a duty to ride the bike according to the side, like whatever the side I have. So in India, if we are going, we will always take our left side. Okay, left side. We go through the left and returning we from right. Is not it? So this is the process. Okay, this is the duty. So this is my duty towards person generally, towards anybody, like who, even if the person over there, or even no matter whatever the situation it be, but the left is my side while going, and while returning right is my side. Okay, so this is the way, this is the way of going, this is the way of so this is the duty primarily fixed by the law. So this is the duty of every person, every citizen. Okay, this is the duty. So if I am riding a bike here, so and I am going this way, so I have not committed any tort or any kind of negligence. Okay, but if I ride a bike in a zigzag shape, okay, in a zigzag manner, or say if I, like, instead of going from the left lane, I took the right lane, so in that case, what? So I will be negligent with my work. I am negligent with my work, and due to that act, if anybody got hurt or injured because of my acts, so that will be what? That will be what? That will be my negligent. That will be that whatever the incident or unfortunate happens, that will be because of my negligent activity. Okay, because I was negligent. Okay, so this is what the negligence in the plain meaning. Okay, like if you owe a duty, if you owe certain duty towards the plaintiff, and if you committed the breach of that duty, so that will be a negligence. Okay, so see, this is a defendant, and he owes a duty towards plaintiff. Okay, so in order to consider, this is the essential also. Okay, like there should be a defendant who owes a duty to take care, okay, duty to care against the plaintiff. Okay, let's suppose I went to a restaurant. Okay, so I went to a restaurant and I asked for the pizza. Okay, I asked for the pizza. Okay, and when the waiter served me a pizza, I find that pizza is rotten, pizza is not in the edible condition. I don't see while looking at the pizza and while looking at the pizza, okay, the pizza looks really good, but the moment I took a one bite of the pizza, it seriously affected my health. I got ill because of that. Because of having the pizza, it caused food poisoning. Okay, so in that case what? So since once I went to the restaurant and I gave the order of pizza, and so the giving an order for the pizza, so that is what I have given the responsibility to the defendant to take care, like while furnishing the duty. Okay, like so it is the duty of the defendant. So in this so it is the duty of the defendant, okay, it is the duty of the defendant to serve me a good pizza, a healthy pizza which is good, which can be eaten without causing any harm. So it is the duty of the defendant, is not it? So if the defendant served me a pizza which is really unhealthy, and like if I find the lizard or all any kind of thing, just it is a hypothesis, okay, I'm just telling you hypothetically. So this could be happened also. We will see later on in the cases, and there are some cases which is you find resembling with this situation. So if the pizza which is being served to me and which is really unhealthy, by taking a one single bite only, it has committed a food poisoning to me. I have got seriously health issues because of that pizza. So that means what? That means what? Defendant has caused the breach of the duty. Okay. So the defendant's duty was to take care and provide me a good food. Okay. So in this respect, his duty is to serve me a good pizza. Okay. So once he breached that duty, so that is what? That is a negligent. Okay. He has committed the negligence, and because of that I have suffered loss. Okay, so this is the example. Okay, so this is what the negligence is. Okay, there should be a duty on the part of the defendant, and the defendant has committed the breach of that duty, and because of that breach the plaintiff suffered a loss. Okay, so that will be a negligence. Okay, here is zimmevarana. In the case of Jacob Matthew, this is the important case law, okay, Jacob Matthew. In this case, the Supreme Court has given the opinion about what is negligence, okay. Jacob Matthew versus State of Punjab. Jacob Matthew versus State of Punjab. So in this case, the Supreme Court has said that in order to constitute negligence, there should be a legal duty to exercise due care, and number two, breach of the said duty. Said duty number three, consequential damage. So this definition is sufficient, okay. Like, so in this Jacob Matthew versus State of Punjab, the Supreme Court has said that in order to constitute negligence, there should be a legal duty to exercise due care on the part of the defendant. The defendant is under the duty to take care or to exercise the due care. Okay. Due care here means the required care. Okay. Suppose I went to a barber. A salon. So what happened? I asked the barber to have my haircut done whatever the way I have, you know, instructed. But he, instead of doing that, he made me a bald. So in that case, what? He has committed the breach. Okay. So a legal duty to exercise due care. So See, once I visited to the salon and I asked my barber to have my haircut done, like say skin fade cut, okay? Skin fade cut. So I have asked him to get me a skin fade cut, okay? But instead of that, what he did something different, okay? Different beyond my instruction. So because of that, like I started looking really dull. I started looking really bad. So that is what. So I, the moment I asked him to, you know, have this like skin fade cut. Okay, I wanted a skin fade haircut. So that means what? The moment I asked him, that means I have given a duty. I have given a duty to that person, and that is a legal duty. Okay, because I am paying certain amount of money for that, right? So I have given the duty to that person. Okay, so. But instead of following my instruction, he did something else according to his will. So because of that, I suffered the loss. The look I was looking for, that look is being lost. Okay, that is not possible after that. So that means what? That means a breach of the said duty. Okay, so in here I asked my barber, number one, I asked my barber to get me a skin fade cut. So but instead of that, he cut something else. So that is a breach of the said duty, and because of that, consequential damage. So because of that, whatever the look I was looking for, that is not possible after that. Okay, so this is the consequential damage. So if three things are present in a situation, then that will be negligence. It was the opinion of the Supreme Court. Okay, now we will see the essential. Okay, according to the book, what are the essentials of the negligence? We will see here. So the defendant owed a duty to care to the plaintiff. It is also same. The defendant owed a duty of care, duty of care to plaintiff number two. The defendant made a breach of that duty. So damage to the plaintiff. So it is also saying the same thing, that the defendant owed a duty of care to the plaintiff, and the defendant made the breach of that duty and the damage to the plaintiff. Okay, so let's see one by one. Okay, let's see one by one in detail. So the defendant owed a duty. Okay, owed a duty. So what duty? Duty to care. Okay, let's make it shorter. Okay, let's make it shorter. So number one is saying that the defendant owed a duty to care. Okay, so what is duty to care? So if we're talking about the care, okay, duty to care, it is not talking about, like we are not discussing about the religious or moral duty. Okay, we are discussing about the legal duty. So legal duty, okay, legal duty to care. Okay, so legal duty to care, we are discussing about the legal duty. Okay, so what is legal duty? We will see. Okay, how and what kind of duty it is like to be furnished by the plaintiff, defendant, against the plaintiff. Okay, so while filing a suit, it is the duty of the plaintiff to establish that the defendant was negligent in his act, and the defendant owed a duty to care me. Okay, suppose if I am going to the court, then I have to establish that the defendant was negligent on his part, okay, because of the defendant I have suffered loss and this things has happened. So it is my duty to establish before the court that the defendant was negligent on his part, and defendant has a duty towards me which he has committed the breach. So I have to establish in the court. Okay, so let's see. And duty to care, so it depends, varies case to cases. Okay, but so let's see in the case of Dongvi versus Stevenson. You have find this case in the contract also. Dongvi versus Stevenson. This case is really important case, okay? Like this case is very, very important. This case is also known as Ginger Beer case, okay? Ginger Beer case. This case is also known as Ginger Beer case. Okay, so in this case, what happened? The plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant. So the facts of the case were like that: the defendant, the plaintiff purchased a ginger beer. Okay, the plaintiff purchased a ginger beer for his partner. Okay, there was a couple, and one of them bought a ginger beer for his partner. Okay, so like the ginger beer which is being bought by the plaintiff, and after the consumption, the plaintiff's partner consumed that drink. Okay, consumed that beer. So after that, what will happen? Like while consuming that, this is the bottle of beer. Let's suppose this is the bottle of beer. Okay, so the bottle was full. Okay, and she was drinking directly from the bottle. Okay, so what happened? Like while the residue, and you know, once he, you know, took the, you know, substantial amount of the beer, and what she notices that there was a, you know, dead snail. There was a dead snail. You know it, right? What is snail? Snail is a, you know, कीड़ा होता है, ठीक है, स्नेल. So there was a snail, a dead, you know, residue of the dead snail inside that bottle. Okay, and before that, and due to that consumption of that like beer, what happened? The plaintiff's partner got sick. Okay, got sick. So that's why the plaintiff filed a suit against the ginger beer company. Okay, and the court said that yes, that the negligence was happened. The defendant was negligent on his duty. The defendant has committed the breach of the duty of care. Okay, so yeah, so if I am a vendor, or if I am producing something, okay, and that is for the public use. Suppose I have a potato chips company. Okay, I have a potato chips company. What happened? Like I have, you know, I used to produce chips, and the chips which is, and I am like saying that this is the one of the finest potato. I am using it for making the potato chips. I am saying that this is the one of the best potato chips, but in reality I am providing them something different, a very unhealthy thing, of potatoes which are not of the good qualities. So that will be what? So I have committed the breach. So if I'm saying that I will give you the best chips in the market, then I have to be the best. And if I'm not, that is what? That is a negligence on my part. And because of my act, if somebody is hurt, then that person will have a right to file a suit against me for the tort of negligence. Okay, so it's the same. It was in the case of the ginger beer case. He bought a ginger beer, and while consuming that ginger beer, she sees the residue of the dead snail. So and due to that consumption, she suffered. She had got food poisoning, and she was severely injured. Her health was, she turned sick. So because of that, that is the duty of the defendant to take care. To provide their customer a good thing. Okay, he cannot just be, he was negligent, because it is beyond imagination that he will find a, you know, residue of the dead snail inside a beer bottle. And if you find the, you know, dead snail inside the beer bottle, that means what? That means a breach, that means a negligence. The defendant was negligent in his act. Okay, so this is the legal duty to care. Okay, And now we will see the second essential. Breach of duty. I suppose that you know the meaning of the breach. Breach means repudiation, or say, you know, violation. Okay, breach means the violation. Okay, so what? So breach of the duty in case of the negligence, it means that non-observance. Okay. Non-observance of due care. So non-observance of the due care, like so if we like once see, we have seen what is negligence. So negligence is what? That the breach of the duty. So breach of the duty, and that duty is what? The duty was to take care of the second person. Okay, so if the person do not observe the, like, so as we have seen the case of the ginger beer case, that the defendant did not like notice that there was a dead snail inside the bottle. So that was the negligent act of the defendant. Okay, so that means what? The defendant has the duty to care, to provide a good a consumable drink to the people who are buying. Okay, so since he did not provide the proper food, so that means he had not observed due care which was being expected from him. Okay, so he has committed the breach of, and it depends, like law does not ask ki you should provide a, you know, greatest amount possible care. Okay, the God is what the law is asking. Law is just asking that the care should be reasonable care. The law is asking just reasonable care. Law is not asking, you know, extraordinary care. Okay, extraordinary care. Law is not asking extraordinary care. Law is just asking the reasonable care, which is supposed to be expected from any individual having a sound mind. Okay, the law is just asking that. Okay, law is not asking extraordinary care. Okay, so simple is that. So even if the person, you know, the breach of the duty, you know, caused because of the extraordinary, like say because of the, you know, and you know, say because of the act of the God, or say some accident, so in that case that will be not called as the negligence. Okay, now the last essential is that damage. So this is the last essential. So what is damage? Damage means the loss, harm, harm, prejudice, whatever. So whatever the loss is being suffered by the plaintiff due to the act of the defendant, because defendant's negligence act, so that will, you know, result in the damage to the plaintiff. And so if the three things are there, like number one, we had the defendant owes a duty to care, and number two, we have breach of the duty, and number three, the damage to the plaintiff. So if the three things satisfied, so that means that will be called as negligence. Okay, so now we will see another concept of the under the negligence. That concept is really important. Okay, so please please listen carefully. Okay, so that the topic is res ipsa loquitur. Res ipsa loquitur. It means things speaks for itself. Things speaks for itself. Okay, so it means the res spell locator. It is an important maxim under the negligence. Okay, res ipsa locator. Things speaks for itself. Okay. So the general rule is that, you know, if the defendant committed the negligence on the part against the plaintiff, then it is the duty of the plaintiff, like burden of the question arises the burden of proof. Okay, burden of proof. Now the plaintiff has to establish that defendant was negligent on his part. It is the responsibility of the plaintiff, once he filed a suit and he wanted a remedy from the court, from the defendant, then the plaintiff files a suit in the court, and it is the duty of the plaintiff to establish that the defendant was negligent on his act, on his part. Okay. But in case of the res ipsa liquitur, the plaintiff is not required, plaintiff will not be asked by the court to prove that the defendant was negligent. Because the act which is being done by the plaintiff, which is being done by the defendant, that speaks for itself that the defendant was negligent. Okay? Defendant was negligent. So let's take the example. I have given you the example at the very initial of this video that, so it is my responsibility if I'm riding a bike, then obviously it is my responsibility while going, I should take the left lane, and while returning, I should take the right lane. Okay, and if, you know, while going only, if I take the right lane and, you know, hit a pedestrian, so that means what? I am negligent, and the defendant is not necessary. It is not necessary on the part of the plaintiff that to prove that I was negligent, because my act itself is saying that I was negligent, because I am taking the wrong lane for riding. Okay, so my act is itself saying that I was negligent. Or say another thing, like if I am, you know, driving a car at a very high speed, okay, at a very excessive speed in the public way, where there is a huge gathering of the public. So I am driving there at a, you know, high speed. So that means what? I am negligent. So it is not it. So in that case, the court will not ask the plaintiff to prove that it was the negligent act of the defendant. The court will not ask, because my act itself is proving that I was negligent. Okay, so there is a very important case law, and that will be called a res ipsa liquitur. That means the act speaks for itself that I was negligent. Okay, simple. So now there is a very important case law, and that case law is being also known as collapse of building structure. Collapse of building structure case. This case is also known as this. Okay, so the case name is Delhi Municipal Corporation of Delhi. Yes. Versus Shobhaganti. In the case of Municipal Corporation of Delhi versus Shobhaganti, okay, this case is also known as collapse of building structure case. Okay, so in this case, there was a clock tower. Okay, there was a clock tower on the market of Delhi. Okay, so the clock tower was broken down, fell down and caused the death of the four people along with the plaintiff. Plaintiff was also injured because of the collapse of that building, the clock tower was collapsed. Okay, so due to that, then the plaintiff filed a suit against the defendant, that is the Municipal Corporation of Delhi, because the clock tower was under the control of the Municipal Corporation of Delhi. Okay, so since the clock tower was under the control of the Municipal Corporation of Delhi, that means the Municipal Corporation of Delhi is responsible for the act because whatever the things is happening around the Delhi and clock tower is under the control. So since the collapsing of that clock tower is the will be termed as that is because of the municipal corporation. Okay, you know why? Because so there was a fact in this case, like so in this case what happened, the generally the clock tower such kind of structure has the life of 30 to 40 years. Okay, 30 to 40 years. So generally the age of such building construction is 30 to 40 years, but since the municipal corporation knew that the building is old now, but still he did not repair it. Okay, the municipal corporation did not repair it or demolished it, you know, in the due time, and the construction was still there for more than 30-40 years. So it is possible that if you do not take care, if you do not repair the building, that will definitely collapse, right? So it happened like that. Okay, so it is, so now, and when the, you know, the clock tower collapsed in the main bazaar of Delhi, so that caused injury, caused death of the many people. Okay, so here, so it is the duty. So how the like, municipal corporation was negligence, let's understand. Okay, so the clock tower age is 30 to 40 years, but he and after that it is the duty of the municipal corporation to take care of that clock tower or to repair it timely or to demolish it, whatever it is possible. It is the duty of the Delhi Municipal Corporation. So the duty did not furnished by the defendant, that means Delhi Corporation Delhi. He did not repair it, and because of that it collapsed. So he committed the breach of the duty, and because of that breach what happened, many people were died. Okay, so this is the case. Okay, this is the clause, res ipsa loquitur. So in this case the plaintiff was not asked, in this case the plaintiff was not asked to prove it, that whether the defendant was negligent or not, because since the municipal corporation has the duty to care, to take care of the clock tower, but he did not, and it collapsed. So which you know depicts that the defendant was negligent on his part. So it is, so the plaintiff is not required to prove that whether the defendant was negligent, because the act of the defendant that he has committed the breach by not taking care of the clock tower, the building structure, you know, collapsed. Okay, and because of that the plaintiff suffered the loss. Simple. So this is a very important topic, and this case law is also very very important. So if you are writing about the res ipsa loquitur, then you have to mention the Municipal Corporation of Delhi versus Sobhagwanti, this case. Okay, so yeah, so this is all about negligence, and if you find this video helpful, and then please hit the like button, and apart from this, if you want to learn how to prepare Assam Judicial Service, then you can visit my channel. There is a playlist I have created for Assam Judicial Service. You will find everything in detail there. So thank you so much once again for watching this video, and have a great day, guys.